by telling them, maybe share with them where you were in your life. And a little bit about your background, because that'll relate, I think they'll relate to that.
I'm Mexican. I was originally born in Mexico, raised here in Florida. I come from a migrant farm working family. And so, like you said, I worked my way up. My mother always taught me, do your best, work your way up, show your best, go out there and just give it all. And that's what I do, you know, and now before it was just for me, now it's for 3 children who depend on me. And like you said, a couple months ago, yeah, I was on my 3rd job trying to get my 4th one. Because like all of us, we want the American dream for ourselves and for our families. And those of you who have children, you know that you want to provide a future for them. Unfortunately, my mother, who passed 12 years ago, I wasn't able to have that future because I had to put, I had to put my college ahead. I had a full paid college tuition. And I had to put that aside because my mom was diagnosed with cancer. There was nobody else to take care of her. So I said, why not? I wanted an opportunity. I had worked all my life to go to college, what I had been taught. And I couldn't do that because I had to take care of my mom, and I wanted to. So I took care of my mom, and she passed away. And after that, of course, I lost my college tuition. But you know what? I said, that's not the end. That's not going to define me. There's more out there.
Mm-hmm.
I had so many life struggles, but I said, you know what? My mother taught me better, and I'm not going to let her death go in vain.
Mm-hmm.
So here I am. You know, I had struggles, and I had 3 children, and yeah, life got the best of me. I gained a little more than I should have. But you know what? Again, I got back up, and I said, this is for me and for my children. I regained my strength. My sanity. I went through a very abusive relationship and marriage, and I got out of it. And and then, you know, God blessed me, you know, because I got a job with Barry, and I'm very fortunate that he took a chance on me, you know, and he's given me so many opportunities that I would have never been given in a normal setting, you know, in a normal JOB setting. And so, of course, I had my children, I was working for him, but, you know, life happens so fast in times in the blink of an eye that you have so much going on. But you want a better future for yourself, for your children, for your family. And I had to go out there and get 3 jobs. I didn't want a waitress. I didn't want to scrub floors, mop floors, be on my knees. I did not want to do that. But you know what? I wanted a better future for my children. And it was okay for me because I also was teaching my children the work ethic that you need so that you can go on and that, you know what, this isn't going to define mommy, but I want to show you that, you know what, we can do this. I had those 3 jobs trying to get my 4th one. And
so what did you see when we showed you?
When he showed me the opportunity of this industry, I said, you know what, why not me? If someone like him, like Ricky and Francoise, you know, are willing to mentor somebody like me,
mm-hmm.
and I'm willing to be coachable, why not? You know, somebody came up to me, I shared this with Francoise the other day, somebody came up to me last week and said, who the heck do you think you are rubbing elbows with those kinds of people? And I said, I'm Marisol. I can do this. I can do whatever I want to do and I set my mind to. And so when they showed me that opportunity, I said, you know what? I don't want to work these 3 and get my 4th job. I don't want that. I got a phone call one night from my boyfriend at Idaho. I'm very blessed to have his support. And my son was crying. And I was in between waitressing tables. And my son says, Mommy, I can't fall asleep. I need you home. I miss you. And I had to get the courage to tell my son, it's going to be okay. Mommy will be home in a few hours. I had to go in a bathroom stall after I got off the phone with him and try to compose myself. And I probably, the lady in the next stall thought I was crazy, crying by myself and talking to myself, giving myself a pep talk. And I just composed myself, gathered my set, and said, this isn't going to define me. Something's got to give. And I said a prayer. And honest to God, the next day he approached me and I said, I gotta go with this. And you know what? I started again from the bottom to the top. I no longer have those jobs. 1 month into doing this type of industry, I was making double than what I was making in all those jobs, you know? And here I am. I'm able to spend more time with my children. I'm more than willing to travel because I know this is life-changing. Because this is an opportunity, like he said, once in a lifetime. Why not take it? Why not you? Why not me? Why not lock arms with Dr. Lynn, Ricky and Francoise, Barry, with both of them? Why not lock arms with people like this who are willing to provide their help and their mentorship? As long as you're coachable, you're willing to have that coachability to learn, and you know what? You can go far. And I like the fact that this type of industry, you can meet anybody, any kind of person off the street, and if you set your mind to it, you can do it.
Mm-hmm. We like that too. It gives us the opportunity to provide something.
So
tell
really
them a little
does.
Bit about what you did just back when the number two recruiter in the company was 8 years old for a month. Number two, 35,000 people. was the number two recruiter at one time.
It was, you know, I started, honestly, I didn't have the possibility, the financial possibility, because I actually had just gotten T-boned a couple of days before, and the person who T-boned my car had no insurance. I had to pay everything out of pocket. That was one of my other reasons why I had to get those two jobs, you know, and you know what, I said, this isn't going to define me. There's something there. There's a silver lining to this. So I said, you know what? I see the possibility. I said to Barry, I didn't even ask questions. I said, what do I do to sign up? I said, if you're making this kind of money, I can make this kind of money. Uh-huh. And you're willing to teach me, and I want to learn. And I can tell you that I came in at the lowest possible thing that you could think of. So I will tell you this. It's possible. You know, someone like me, I say little old Mexican me, from Date City, the little town Date City, that can do it, you can do it.
Yeah.
It's possible, you know, and once you lock arms with people like these who have a serving heart, and you feel the Dallin effect, you're going to go far, mm-hmm. You know, and honestly, I want to go far. I want to go up. I want to teach people. I want to help people. Other moms, not only in Florida, all over the world. Moms, dads, grandpas, grandmas, you know, like Barry, like, you know, Ricky and Francoise and Dr. Lynn and his wife. They want to help everybody. I want to help people who were in a rut like me get out of it. They don't let that define them, because that doesn't have to define you. I see myself going far. You know, and I was just telling that apple the other day. I said, you know what? When I get to meet Dallin, because I'm going to meet Dallin.
That's right.
Myself, I'm going to meet Dallin. I am just going to give him a big smooch on the kiss and a big hug. I said, because you couldn't have done this at the best possible time. Because this is something that I've been honestly praying for. And it's a prayer answer. And I am ever, ever grateful to Barry for giving me the chance. For allowing me to, for actually believing more in me, Kim, Ricky, Francoise, they believe more in me than I believe in myself sometimes. And honestly, with them being here for us, I mean, for Ricky and Francoise to travel all the way from Jacksonville, that means so much to me. For me to have a phone call, heart-to-heart phone call with Francoise at night, you know, when she knows that I don't normally go to bed until midnight because I'm having to prepare for the following day after the day because I'm OCD. Having heart-to-heart talks like that. When am I going to find that in a normal job setting? Somebody like that call me and say, hey, how are you doing? What's going on? How can I help you? You know, you don't find that anywhere. And, you know...
And just if you wanted to know, it's not affected her job. That club is still at double digit gains, right? And she runs the damn thing. So it's at double digit gains there. So it doesn't affect, it hasn't taken anything away from.
It's added.
It's added.
So I can tell you, it's added my confidence. It's added my self-esteem. My children, you know, I told them, I said, Mommy's going to a meeting. And they gave me a big hooray when I left, and they said, go get them, Mommy, you know, because they see the value in the fact that the little sacrifice now is better than me having those other four jobs where I would just wake up, drop them off at school, pick them up, and, you know, drop them off at the sitters, head on from one job to the other, you know, they see the value in it as well. and
that's an amazing story.
I know.
Right? I mean, mine's like, okay, do another business, who cares? That's what we're able to do, mm-hmm. right? And that'll get you up in the morning. And for me, you know, and I know Ricky, he's got a certain, I always joke to Orlando too, just like I did. You know, we're in this to try to impact people's lives. We want 100 more stories like that, right? So if you see yourself in any way, shape, form, or fashion, being someone, somewhere or some point, it's something that she's had to overcome. She's overcome a lot. And I would strongly suggest taking that step, taking a chance on yourself, right? Because you have people here. We absolutely do care. I mean, this is one example. We have some others as well. This is one that I think will speak into a lot of people's hearts. Right? Thank you all, Sandy.